Welcome to English class, children. Is nouns. In the previous classes, you have done all the naming words are nouns, but this time nouns are the names of people, places, animals, things, and ideas and feelings also. So, children, basically we will do kinds of nouns. We have four types of nouns in class 6. Proper noun, common noun, collective nouns, and abstract nouns. So the very first I am going to explain, proper nouns are the particular names, the specific name of a person, place, animals, things. Okay, like Ahmed, Radha, Delhi. Common nouns are the general names. General names means boy, girl, man, river, sea, any of the, not a particular name. Collective noun, we have done already, we learned a lot in previous classes, like a group of people, group of animals, or group of the things, like an army of soldier, bunch of keys, bundle of sticks, etc. Finally, the last one, abstract nouns. These nouns denote an idea or a quality. You will feel like adjectives are there, but these are not adjectives. These are a state of being something, like beauty, strength, love. Children, I usually, this is my way of teaching, that by practicing or solving exercise, you will come to understand the things, because definitions, they don't come in the exam, we don't give. So, you focus on solving the exercises. So, you will get all the exercises, like underline the nouns and put them in the correct column. So, you can do it very easily. In previous classes, you have done. And B, you have a word grid and use them to complete this. This is a collective noun. Very common ones are given, well known to you. Easily. Here, use suitable suffixes from abstract noun. Like children, just, justice, hate, hatred, child, childhood, like this. So now we have a number. From UKG onward, children, you are doing one, many. Here, some nouns are can be counted, some cannot be. If you can't count, these are uncountable nouns. If you can count, these are countable nouns. So, children, uncountable nouns, water, soil, bravery, honesty, iron, these are given. And countable are very clear to you. You can count down. But here, some nouns are there. You can make it positive nouns. Like in notes, you can see, you can make uncountable nouns a countable one. You can convert it by adding some, like chocolate, a bar of chocolate, furniture, four pieces of furniture, like this. You can make uncountable noun to countable. And singular and plural are very clear to you. In the next slide, I am going to check rules, children. This is very important, page number 15. Kindly go through many times and see the rules. So not only adding S or ES at the end are the rules, there are some more rules. So rule number one, simple adding S. If you have S, SH, SSCH or X at the end of the word, then ES will be added. If you have O at the end of the word, then you have to check that before O, what is the letter, consonant, ES. If vowel, then only S. Then at the end, if you have Y, then again there are two rules. If Y and before that you have a consonant, you will simply add IES. And if you have a vowel before Y, then you will add only S, right? And if you have the F letter at the end of the word, noun, then VES will be added. Dwarf, dwarves, leaf, leaves, knife, knives. And some exceptions are there. There will be no S or ES at the end. Man, men, goose, geese, foot, feet. You have to learn, children, these ones. Some more exceptions are given, salmon, deer, jewelry, information. These are always in a plural form. You do not have to add any S or ES or anything, right? Some unchanging words are there. They don't change. They are already in a plural form. Oats, trousers, pliers, tweezers, scissors. These are already in a plural form. You don't have to do anything for that. And you have a exercise D, E, you have to do it. And then compound nouns are given, children. Compound noun means a word is a one word noun. Sometimes it is of two words, sometimes hyphenated. Like bedroom is one word, there is no space. Bus stop, there is one space. And son-in-law, there are two hyphens in between. So when you make plural of these compound words, you have to add s to the principal word. You have to understand which one is the main one, the principal one, like mother-in-law, mothers-in-law. And some s will be added if you do not understand which one is the principal word, means which one is the main word. If you don't understand, then at the end you will add s, forget-me-nots, bus stops, like that. Now, plural form of nouns of foreign words are given, children. You know, in English language, there are very few words, around 800 something words are there original. Words are borrowed from Latin and Greek. So, these are the very common words. We know the words bacteria, data, criteria, phenomena. You might have heard. You must have heard, I know. So, see, these are the plural words. So, what is the singular of bacteria? Bacterium. Data, datum. So you go through it. Most of the children are very sharp. I know your brains are very sharp and fresh. You go through this table, you will learn more and more. But rules are also given. Children, please go through this and solve this. I have a time. If I make a video more than 10 minutes, it is not going to be uploaded. And now, children, this crossword puzzle is only in new book. In old book, it is not given. So enjoy this crossword puzzle. Do by your own. The key which I am going to give you, you will not get the answer of this. Enjoy this. Try it. This is very easy, not very difficult. I know you can do it. And then H, rewrite these sentences. You have to make plural of the all highlighted blue words. Fox, foxes, deer, deer, two teeth. So like that. Children, gender, I'm not going to do in this video. In the next one we will do. The chapter is very long, so by this time please go through the rules of the number, that is how to make plural of the singulars, what are the rules, learn the collective nouns, take care of abstract nouns, go through more and more. And key I am giving, obviously, but please do not copy the key very first. You try out first, you know you can do it. And in this lockdown condition, you're not very tired. I think you are full of energy. You try and use your energy ability best. Please take it out, and we will wish for you. Stay blessed, stay healthy, stay at home and follow, obey your parents, do something nice for your parents. I will always wish that we'll meet, and I'll be interacting with you, teaching you. I'm missing you too much, children. Thank you very much. Try out. And don't bother about the notebook in English one. Please go through the book, do more and more exercise. Thank you, children.